Very good morning to all of you.
Good morning, sir.
With the grace of Almighty, on behalf of Rayat Shikshan Sanstha's Sadguru Gadge Maharaj College, Karad, I am Mahesh Gaikwad, librarian, SGM College, Karad. A very warm welcome you all on the one-day webinar of Efficient Measures for Writing a Research Paper, Its Publication and Access to E-Resources. I begin the program by expressing my gratitude towards the Dr. Mohan Rajmani sir, principal of Sadguru Gadge Maharaj College, Karad, for giving us the direction. I also express my gratitude to the all vice principals of our college, principals of all mentee colleges, those are attended this webinar. Dear participants, we know the writing of research paper is an utmost requirement of academic and research career. Writing a research paper is an art, and we need to inculcate within us. We are done our work and we want to get it published. In this regard, we have to tailor and design our work and present it in most simple and efficient way to the journal, to the editor, to the reviewer, or ultimately to the reader. For this, we must be familiar with the fundamental of writing a publishing of research paper. This webinar will help to get the knowledge about the writing, publishing, and accessing research paper. On behalf of HM College, Karad, I heartily welcome the research person of today's webinar. I also welcome all of you participants who have given overwhelming response for the webinar. I would also like to welcome my webinar team member, Professor G.B. Kalyan Chetty sir, IQAC coordinator of HM College, Karad, for his all efforts behind the curtain. Now, I would like to request Professor G.B. Kalyan Chetty sir, please introduce today's resource person and also share our views about today's webinar. Thank you. Thank you very much. Over to Professor Kalyan Chetty sir.
Thank you. Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Very good morning to all of you.
Kalyan Chetty, sir. Patima kun awaaz yetoy khup.
Yeto awaaz clear?
Awaaz yetoy clear. Patima kun jar awaaz yetoy jaast.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good morning to all of you. Honorable Principal Dr. Mohan Rajmani Sahib, today's resource person Dr. Prakash Bilawar, all the respected principals of mentee colleges, all the respected IQAC coordinators of mentee colleges, all the respected faculty of senior college, Asia College Karad, and friends. It is indeed a pleasure for me to greet you at this very interesting moment for which we have gathered virtually in the name of this webinar. Internal Quality Assurance Cell, Sadguru Gadge Maharaj College, Karad, has been functioning by conducting various activities that promote quality culture in all the academic endeavors. We did have one webinar in the month of May, in which we try to address virtually smart tools for teaching and research. This is the second attempt on behalf of Internal Quality Assurance Cell, Kishorao Pawar Library, AGM College, Karad, that we are organizing this webinar. This webinar is quite urgent, what I feel, because it addresses a very important attribute of NAAC assessment in particular and higher education in general. We, the fraternity, the teaching fraternity, we have been motivated to publish our research work, to undertake research projects, major projects, minor projects, and we have been doing it. But since UGC expects the fraternity to publish the research papers, research pursuits in the very esteemed journals that have been approved by UGC. So today's webinar, that is entitled Efficient Measures for Writing Research Paper, Is Publication and Access to E-Resources. So this is very urgent and very important that would definitely help all of us to enrich our research pursuits. And for this webinar, we have Dr. Prakash Bilawar with us from Shivaji University, Kolhapur. It is indeed a pleasure for me to introduce his scholarship to all of the members present for this webinar. Dr. Prakash Bhairu Bilawar. He has been serving as an assistant librarian in Barrister Balasaheb Kharedekar Knowledge Resource Center, Shivaji University, Kolhapur, Maharashtra. He has done his BSc, BLib, MLib, and Information Science. He has also gone through NET examination and he has completed PhD in Library and Information Science. He has put in more than 24 years of his service, out of which he has served 9 years at Finolex Academy of Management and Technology, Ratnagiri. And for the last 15, 16 years, he has been with us with the apex body of Shivaji University, Kolhapur. As far as his academic and research pursuits are concerned, he is specialized in information technology, academic libraries, information resources, services, and information literacy. Along with this, he has also extended his expertise as a teacher. He is also having a teaching experience. He has taught 3 years at PG level and 15 years at PG level at BLI and MLI. He's been a research guide to 20 students. So 20 students have been pursuing their research for MPhil and PhD under his able guidance. He has completed his PhD on the topic Awareness of Information Literacy Amongst University Teachers of Maharashtra. So this particular title signifies that which has been a talk of a day nowadays during this lockdown. And after this COVID-19 or the post COVID-19, the entire higher scenario is going to be quite different from what we had some 3 or 4 months before. So he has completed his PhD on Awareness of E-Information Literacy Amongst University Teachers of Maharashtra. As far as his research work is concerned, I'm going to list out some of his important publications, but whatever the research work that he has done so far, he has 33 citations to his credit, out of which there are 3 H index according to Google Scholar. So research guide recognition, he is an MPhil and PhD guide. As far as his research publication is concerned, till now, he has published his research work in 16 journals, out of which 11 are of national level and 5 are of international level. So all these papers he published in various journals, they address the various domains, the various attributes of library science, information, and Knowledge Research Center. Further, he has also written some books. He has till date 2 books to his credit, 1 national and 1 international. These books are entitled, he has published them during 2018 and 2012. The books are Essentials of Information Literacy and E-Information Literacy for Information Seekers, that has been published by New Delhi by SS Publications. He has been a co-author in which he had put his expertise on the publication of the book, Current Trends in Ayurvedic Medical College Libraries in Kolhapur District, Maharashtra, a study. It has been published abroad by Lapp Lambert Academic Publishing, Germany. So he has 5 books to his books that he has edited. The book on Regional Seminar on Collection Development in IT Environment on 13th of October 2006, Compendium of Research, Doctoral Thesis, January 1999, Convocation Address, Proceedings of National Conference, 2014, and Fetch Shift in Honor of Dr. N.I. Divantar, The Parameters and Perspectives of LIS Education. So these are the books that are to his credit as a co-author. 13 chapters he has contributed in publishing the books. Along with this, he has also attended various conferences, seminars, workshops at national and international level. Till date, he has been instrumental in attending 12, scenarios, out of which 8 national and 4 international. So 8 national publications and 4 international publications till date are to his credit. It is indeed a pleasure to have Dr. Dilawar, really. And along with this, he also is quite productive in addressing various issues in local newspapers. Professional membership he holds. He is a life member of ILA, that is Indian Library Association. He's been a member. Manulibnet, it is a management library network. He's also the member of which. Maharashtra University and College Library Association, that is MULCA, is also a member of his. Along with this, professional, co-curricular, extracurricular activities are many. But one of the certain things I would like to mention here, he has been an internal auditor, ISO 9001:2015. He was also a NAC coordinator for BBK Library since 2008 till date. He worked as the examiner for assessment as well as moderator, as well as co-paper setter for the work of Bachelor of Library Science, Master of Library Science, MPhil and PhD. He is involved as a contributory teacher for BLIB and Information Science course at DLSI, both for theory and practical examination. He is a member in advisor committee for national conferences, the member of editorial board for publication of books under Golden Jubilee event of the Shivaji University Kolhapur. And his scholarship, his expertise has invited him to various countries. He had been to various foreign countries where he had delivered his expertise addressing library information science. Till date, he has visited Bangkok, Thailand, and we wish that he would definitely visit all other European countries through which he would go on heralding the expertise of library science and information. So with these words, I really feel very proud to mention his scholarship at this webinar. And I, on behalf of Internal Quality Assurance Cell, SGM College Karad, I extend a very warm welcome to Prakash Dilawar, sir. And I hope, definitely, I am quite sure about it, that his expertise on this given topic will definitely help the fraternity of SGM College to enrich the research pursuits, and whatever the grade that we're enjoying today, it will definitely enhance its standard in the next coming years. So with these words, I wish a good time to all of you and a good time to Prakash Dilawar as well. So over to Mahesh. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. त्यानंतर मी महाविद्यालयाचे प्राचार्य आदरणीय डॉक्टर मोहन राजमाने साहेब यांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी मार्गदर्शन करावं.
व्हेरी गुड मॉर्निंग ऑन ऑल.
गुड मॉर्निंग साहेब.
रिसोर्स पर्सन ऑफ टुडेज वेबिनार डॉक्टर प्रकाश दिलावर सर, आयक्यूएसी कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर गिरीश कल्याण शेट्टी, श्रीयुत महेश गायकवाड सर, the principals of Menti colleges, participants and friends. The today's webinar entitled Efficient Measures for Writing Research Paper, Its Publication and Access to E-Resources is associated with NAC. As we know, in NAC, criteria number 3, research, innovation, and extension. The today's subject is related with this criteria number 3, which is very important as far as NAC. As we know, each and every teacher in college should write a research paper in reputed journal. I expect this is done in every college, but UGC has given a code of conduct where the research paper is published. There is a list of core journal. which is published on UGC website. UGC असेल विद्यापीठ असेल किंवा कॉलेज असं अपेक्षित करत आहे प्राध्यापकांच्याकडून की प्राध्यापकांचं जे पब्लिकेशन आहे एक चांगले जर्नलमध्ये व्हावं की ज्याला हाय इम्पॅक्ट आहे आणि म्हणून महाविद्यालयाकडून वेळोवेळी प्राध्यापकांना फायनान्शियल असिस्टंट दिलं जात आहे. या कराडच्या महाविद्यालयाकडून देखील प्राध्यापकांनी चांगलं संशोधन करावं त्यांना प्रोत्साहन मिळावं या उद्देशाने मार्च महिन्यामध्ये लॉकडाऊन सुरू होण्याच्या अगोदर जवळजवळ 21 प्राध्यापकांना फायनान्शियल सपोर्ट दिलेला आहे की जेणेकरून चांगल्या रिसर्च व्हावा चांगलं पब्लिकेशन व्हावं. मी म्हणेन की आपण प्राध्यापक नेहमी लिखाण करतो परंतु रिसर्च पेपर लिहिणं आणि इतर लिखाण लिहिणं यामध्ये थोडा फरक आहे आणि रिसर्च पेपर अतिशय चांगल्या पद्धतीनं लिहिला जावा या दृष्टिकोनातून आजच्या या वेबिनारची आपण तयारी केलेली आहे. आजचे रिसोर्स पर्सन डॉक्टर प्रकाश बिलावर सर आत्ताच कल्याण शेट्टी सरांनी त्यांची ओळख करून दिली. त्यांच्या या मनोगतामधून आपणाला यापुढच्या कालावधीमध्ये रिसर्च पेपर लिहिण्यासाठी जी काही कला आत्मसात करावी लागेल ती निश्चितपणे आजच्या या वेबिनारमधून आपणाला मिळेल अशी मी अपेक्षा व्यक्त करतो. आणि महाविद्यालयामधून अजून देखील कुणाला जर संशोधन करायचं असेल तर त्याला निश्चितपणे फायनान्शियल सपोर्ट देखील दिला जाईल अशा प्रकारचं मी या ठिकाणी शब्द देतो. या वेबिनारसाठी महाविद्यालयाकडून शुभेच्छा देतो आणि थांबतो.
धन्यवाद साहेब. नाव आय वुड लाईक टू रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर प्रकाश बिलावर सर असिस्टंट लायब्ररियन बॅरिस्टर बाळासाहेब खर्डेकर रिसोर्स सेंटर शिवाजी युनिव्हर्सिटी कोल्हापूर. प्लीज स्टार्ट द सेशन. ओवर टू बिलावर सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल.
गुड मॉर्निंग.
नमस्कार.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आय मस्ट थँक डॉक्टर मोहन राजवान सर द प्रिन्सिपल ऑफ सद्गुरु गाडगे महाराज कॉलेज कराड फॉर गिविंग यू एन अपॉर्च्युनिटी टू प्लेस बिफोर यू इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर वेबिनार. आय एम ऑल्सो थँकफुल to Dr. J.B. Kalyan Shetty sir for nice introduction over to me. And the last but the not the least, I am thankful to my student and the librarian of SGM College Karad, Mr. Mahesh Gaikwad. So without wasting a lot of time, I directly go to the PPT. So now I'm sharing the screen sharing.
Yes, sir.
Mahesh, it is audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, but
and PPT?
Still not, sir.
PPT is not shared?
Still not, sir.
I'll check. Shared?
Just a minute, sir. Still not, sir. Sir, please,
yes, sir.
Once again, share.
Now check.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Got it.
Is there?
Yes, 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 sir.
So the title of today's webinar is Efficient Measures for Writing a Research Paper, Its Publication and Access to E-Resources. If you can look at this particular title, I am going to highlight the three aspects. The first one is, what will be the efficient measures for writing a research paper? Then, what is the publication criteria? How it can be get to public? And for publication and the writing, what are the different kinds of e-resources that can be available nowadays? We'll see. Okay. So I start my PPT with the WH question. As you know, in the research, there must be a WH questions, right? Which means go to the why, what, why, how, like that. So the first question will be, why research? Why we can undertake the research? Or why to write a research paper or the article? What is the research design? What are the channels of scholarly communications? What are the basics of article writing? Dr. Mohan Rajamani sir told about the different kinds of the skills that can be useful for writing a paper. So we'll be discussing that. Then what are the things to be avoided in research writing? Certain things are there. So considering this, we can avoid the what we can call as the paper, how to write like that. Then what are the fundamentals of research publications? What are the basics of research publication? Publications from the research or either from the internet sources, and how to select a journal for article publication. We're going to see. Okay. So why research? As you know, if we can look at this particular word, that is research, there is a re/search is there. Okay. What it means, the search is there, but where to again research it. Just like what is called as engineering. We may call this as a re-engineering. Or the cycle, we may call it as a recycle. So it is what is called as it is a continuous process. But why we can study or why we can take the research? Because of it is going to be a societal relevance. It can be definitely useful for the society. Take our burning chapter today's, what is called as this COVID-19. What is the societal relevance? If the vaccine of this particular COVID-19 will be get generated, then it can be definitely useful for the societal relevance. That is why the different kinds of the researchers, different kinds of the research institutions or scientists are trying for development of this vaccine against this COVID-19. Then it has a generation of new knowledge. Whenever a research goes on, it can generate new knowledge. We may call as an innovative knowledge. We may call as a novel knowledge. And that can be useful for the society, and there is a need of this particular, today's need is this generation of new knowledge. Then it means the scope or further research. There must be a scope or further research. And as you know, the research is a continuous process. If there is one research stops, ultimately the new research will begin. So it is a continuous process, we may call a spiral of continuous process. After one research, next research will start. Like that, the work goes on. So the word that is called as research is there. Then why to write a research paper or the article? If we can look at the publication that can be made by elsewhere, that is for the 5 data I have collected, here it can give the total publication output along with the authors. Here India comes in the fifth country with the scholarly output of, say something, 9,49,888. That is scholarly output, and the authors become 8 lakh. Whereas US is on the top position with the scholarly output of 40 lakh as compared to over 9 lakh. And the author is up 29 lakh as compared to author of 8 lakh. So there is a diversity is there. So as Dr. Rajamani sir said, or the Kalan city said, we must come forward for the research so that it can be useful for our country, for our NAC, for our NIRF, then only we can go for the further thing in the global world. So the first fact is that you can cherish your own work, means you have to give your value to the own work. If you do not take care, why should the journal? So the research is a scholarly thing, we may call it a scientific thing. Once we have in your mind that I am going to conduct a research, then the scientific thinking or the we may call as idea begins. So oftenly it can be called as scientific thinking. So cherish your own work. Then if the reviewer editor has misunderstood something, then you have not explained enough. That's why your scholarly publications cannot be get published in a well-reputed journals. So you must know what are my output of the research. where I can put that particular output, and which is the peer journal, which is the reviewed journal. So here I can got my journal published in a reputed journal of international level. So for that purpose, we have to undertake the research. Okay. Then this is the general thing. A lot of library science people know what is this research design or this particular, which includes the different criteria for this design. It includes the need, importance, objectives, research methodology, scope, maybe three, that is called a geographical scope, topical scope, and analytical scope, hypothesis, null, alternative research, review literature, inferences, then interpretation and the presentation, various means of statistical and inferential mode for testing of this particular hypothesis or the finding of particular results, the use of Excel presentation with the help of the tables, figures, graph, discussion finding, like that we will go. I cannot focus on this particular issue, but for the beginnings, it must know what is the research design and what are these different components. Then in continuation, the research design, it includes the research methods. Basically, there are four methods, as you know, historical, comparative, experimental, descriptive. Apart from that, there are other research methods are there applicable for the different disciplines. Say, for example, this historical, that can be applicable for the history people like that, or experimental, that can be useful for the science people. So apart from that four, there are different kinds of the other historical, other research methods are there. And there are different kinds of data collection tools are there. It may be interview method, it may be this observation, it may be the survey, it may be the record analysis, it may be the checklist, it may be the questionnaire. So this is conclude, or this include what is called as the research design, which includes all these parameters. Then what are the scholarly ways of communication we may call as channels of communications, where we are going to publish our research? It may be a journal article, it may be a magazine article, it may be a newspaper article, it may be a newsletter that can be published weekly like that. Or you can publish your paper in the conference paper or the working paper. The difference between conference paper, as you know, it can be get published in this conference proceedings, whereas working paper, these are before publication papers are there. We want to do, or if we want to submit the working papers, obviously there are some agencies are there, they can publish it, or the discussion papers are there. Then, as you know, the book and the book chapter of a book that can be edited by somebody, and your contribution will be there as a one author for this particular chapter, like that, the book chapter or little book or the books. Then preprint and the postprints, that is the way of scholarly communication. Then other article, which includes the review article or the web articles also. And the different kinds of open ends, say for example, a blog post or the policy brief, that come under this also in this scholarly communication. And there will be other form that is called a short communication, and there are many more. What I present here, that is the scholarly communication, and the gist is that we have to find out the gaps in the research. Means what? If I have done a research, then whether it is going to publish in a reputed journal, or whether I can publish this particular article in a magazine or a book chapter, we have to decide. But these are the ways of scholarly communication. Then, planning for article writing. So there are four quadrants I have shown here, which is useful for article writing. Here we can look, the question that is, I have done something new and innovative. Whenever you undertake the research, you must take into note that your research should be unique, new, and innovative. Then only it has value. Then only, once it has value, then only it can be get a recognition in the reputed journals of international or the national literature. Then it should be a need-based and relate to the current situation. Say, for example, now a period of this COVID-19. Say, for example, I can write a paper on what is called as a lockdown period. Okay, lockdown period, it is a current situation. But where, if I can say or classify something like that lockdown 1, lockdown 2, lockdown 3, and unlock 1.0, and the mapping of lockdown 1.0 to unlock 1.0, that will be your current situation where to it should be related to that particular things. Then methodology and solutions should be mobile. If I take earlier example, lockdown 1.0 and unlock 1.0, where is the methodology? Which methodology you are going to adopt? Or what will be the solutions for that? You may compare the what is called as the relaxation, what is called as the things in lockdown 1.0, unlock 1.0. That should be the methodology and the solutions over it. And after that, the last one is suggestions, conclusions for further improvement. From that, we can suggest them, say something. Say, for example, in the future, it will be going to be unlock 2.0. Then what will be your suggestions? Like that, we have to give for further improvement of the system. So this is a four quadrant of this, what is called as planning for article writing. Then now we'll go for the basics of article writing. That is the first part in this particular webinar, is the basics of article writing. The first one that is called as formulate research question, that is called as RQ. It should be creative and novel. As I said earlier, the idea or what is called as the question should be creative and novel. Once in your mind, something that can be made, and once it can be made, we can apply it for the current situation, then the question or the research question that can be planned. So while planning, once we have a research question, then we can apply it for different things. Say, for example, in our domain, say from some people are from science, some people are from arts, then depending upon their domain, they can create their research question or the title or this particular research. Then one can go for the multidisciplinary also, along with science, other social sciences. And depending upon that, as you know, in the domain, there are different journals. In the multidisciplinary factor also, there are different kinds of journals are there. Then, as I said, one can take the research of the current origin as well as the retrospective also. Say, for example, somebody says that the thing now happening in this COVID-19, it was there for the last 100 years. That is something in the year 1887 like that. That is the plague, which is like that. So that will be retrospective. That is what is the situation in the 18th and what is the situation in today's. It may be a point of this particular research question. Then we have the basic or the applied research where to undertake. That is called as pure or the applied research or the empirical thing we have to take into consideration. Or it will be conceptual. Conceptual means that is idea panel is there. It may work, it may not be work. That is called as a part regarding this suggestion part. That is called as conceptual writing. And the last will be that is called as questionnaire design. You must design a questionnaire depending upon the research question, depending upon the objectives. We'll see later what are the different kinds of this what is called as the parameters of the research writing. Then the think before writing. Why I'm focusing is that unless you think, you cannot generate any kind of idea. Once you have generated the idea, it becomes your data in the paper. And as you know, when the data that can be organized systematic way, it becomes your information. And again, if the information that can be organized systematic way, it becomes your knowledge and knowledge that can become into the wisdom. So there is a chain is there. So think before writing. You must have an idea. You must have a novel concept. Then only you can go for it. And while writing, your language should be very clear and the correct. The language should be very clear and the correct. If the poor language is there, the reviewer or the editor may say, oh, this is a poor language, we may reject like that. So your language should be clear and should be correct. Okay. Then apply accepted article structures. If you can look at this particular journal homepage, then they have given what is called as author's guideline, in which they can have a, what is called as the priorities there. Say, for example, abstract, then followed by keywords, followed by introduction, followed by so many things. So apply accepted article structure. Be prepared for a revision or the questions. Once you upload a particular, what is called as, once you completed this article and you are posted this particular article in a reputed journal database or the journal editor, then they may think, or they may direct about the revision or a particular point. It may be regarding introduction, it may be the research methodology, it may be the regarding the result. So what will be the editors' revisions are there, who must incorporate, who must answer that particular revision or the questions, then we can go for the further things. So be prepared for the questions as well as the revisions that may be going to be asked in the future by the editor or the journal experts. So the thing is that it can promote your own paper or the manuscript. So whatever the idea is there, it can be get promoted. It can be get promotion of your own idea or the manuscript in their particular things. Then after the research question, the title we have to suggest. Title we have to suggest. So I am giving here the three examples. Okay, so what would be the title? Say, for example, perception, diffusion, investigation, expectation of information literacy amongst the college users in India with special reference to Maharashtra. So it is a vague title, counting about 20 words. So I must focus on what is the college user, what is the meaning of perception, what is the diffusion, or what is the investigation? Is these words are correlated with each other like that, I think. And from that thing, I can suggest another title as investigation of information literacy amongst the senior and junior college teachers. Here the college users are there, it can get replaced by the senior and junior college teachers in India with special reference to Maharashtra. From that, we have again counted the minimum word size. Then I must go further. What about the investigation? Or whether the teachers are from the senior colleges or from the junior colleges, then again, what I can suggest one title which is going to be of 14 words, that is investigation and expectation, which includes all. All means the perception, diffusion, investigation, and expectation regarding what? Information literacy amongst the senior college teachers in Maharashtra. Now, again, I am not satisfied with this particular title. And finally, I can come to know about the unique title, which is called as awareness and use of information literacy amongst the college teachers in South Maharashtra. That will be the specific title for my research. If you can look at this, the first one that is called the very vague, prior to that, it is disciplinarized, again disciplinarized, and can come to the final one, that is awareness and use of information literacy. So your target should be focused on information literacy, and your population will be the college teacher from the South Maharashtra, and the variables will be the awareness and the use. So what I wanted to share here is that your title should be short and specific, isn't it? So whatever the title is there, you can minimize it, you can shorten it, and should be specific. Say, for example, earlier example, lockdown 1.0 and unlock 1.0. What is the title? Comparison between lockdown 1.0 or unlock 1.0, or comparison between unlock 1.0 with regard to the lockdown 1.0. Like that, should be a short and specific. Then only, depending upon the title, we can go for the further things. So your title should be short and specific. The next thing is abstract. So you have to spend more time in the abstract. It should be based on the current situation. You have to include the major findings and what are the implications that you have studied in your research in minimum words or the texts. Approximately, if you can count, it is around 50 to 300 words, or just only the tail lines of the abstract will be there. Then you can include the keyword. It may be of 5 or 6 that can be useful for further indexing of the journals. Then it is recommended. The interest recommended as you have to write abstract in such a way that it has the purpose. Then design methodology, which method you are to apply. What will be the approaches? Then major findings. what is the originality of the particular research, what is the value, and the paper type, whether the paper is the article type, whether the paper is what is called as book review, like that we have to tell about the paper type. So this particular abstract can be counted as a tailor of a full view. Depending, we will visit, we will see the movie, but before that we have to watch the trailer, and from the trailer we can have idea about the full movie. Then we can plan whether we can going to see the full movie or not. So your abstract should be what is called as very specific, and you have to spend more time to write a particular abstract. Then only we can go for, then only the authors or the others can read the full text. The next is the introduction. So I have to introduce the introduction. Here you can add the basics or your preliminaries, whatever the things are there. You may add the definitions, concepts, or the views of an expert, which are going to be made in this particular your suggested title. Then you have to add the need, what will be the importance, and the statement of problem. And generally, it is not more than 20 lines or the 250 words. So to make the introduction in this particular 20 lines, or we may have a two paragraph introduction will be sufficient. And the introduction should be clear. We cannot include what is called as garbage or the other related unrelated things in this introduction. It should be clear. It should be balanced, and it should be well organized. Well organized means we have to write something basic. Then we have a definitions like that. Or if you want to start your introduction with a definition, it is not well organized. So after 2-3 lines about this basic or preliminaries, we may add the definition or the concept or the views. So it should be well organized. Then the most important part is to review of literatures. So as you know, there are different kinds of sources of informations are there. Here it may be Indian, it may be original, it may be foreign. It should be relevant to the title or the scope. Depending upon your title or the scope, you can add the. Just like earlier example, there is what is called as awareness and use of information literacy amongst the college teacher of Maharashtra. So we can, this particular title can be get into many captions or break into many captions. Say for example, awareness, youths, information literacy, college teacher, or the Maharashtra. So I can take one as awareness, and after taking this awareness as a caption, I can search for the reviews. It may be of the Indian, or it may be of the foreign origin. Then I can go for the youths. I can go like that. I can go for the information literacy. I can go for the college teacher. Like that, we can make the review of literature. While reviewing, you must have or you must get acquainted with other things also. Say for example, while reviewing, I can come across one particular article which is very beneficial or which is very relevant to my topic. So read that particular full paper and take the notes. Take the notes means whatever the important parts or points are there, you can highlight it and you can add in your study. Like that, you can prepare your the questionnaire also. Like that, you can prepare your the bibliography also. Well, your literature serves three basic functions. What is that? It is useful for to write the questions in the questionnaire. Then it is useful for the review of literature, and it is useful for the writing the bibliography or the references. So side by side, you can work. And there are different sources of information, ranging from conventional to the modern, and you know that's from primary to tertiary. Primary, for example, the journal. If you can look at this primary source for modern, it would be e-journal, newspaper. The modern source will be the databases, and the search engine is for the tertiary sources along with this encyclopedia as the conventional source. So we may take the help of either the conventional as well as the modern source of information for writing the review of literature. It may be primary, it may be secondary, it may be the tertiary. Take one example here. What is that? The importance of punctuation. See the statement. Let's it grandfathers. Means we are suggesting something like that. Let's eat grandfather. What will be the output? Grandfather will eat, or we have to eat grandfather like that. But the correct is let's eat. There is comma is there. Grandfather means you have suggested grandfather. Let's eat. It's the time to take your dinner. It's the time to take your breakfast. So the importance of punctuation is there. So your review of literature, it should be unique and it should be updated. Suppose you are taking one research, you are doing your research, and you are taking last what is called as 20 years back review. It's of no use nowadays. You can take if you can going for retrospective search or retrospective research. So your bibliography or your review of literature should be unique, updated, and should be need based. Then only it can be get accepted by the editors. Then prior to that, next will be the objectives. So here we have to add the objectives. It should be a purpose based. It should be to study, compare, know something. It has an idea or intention, and should be a SMART goal. Means what? A stands for the specific. Should be specific. Depending upon your title, you can modify or you can make your objectives, and it is specific, unique, not more than that. It should be measurable. Means it should be accountable. It should be accountable. Suppose I want to take a data of 300 students, then it should be measurable. Suppose if I can take a data of 3000, it is measurable or not, you are to depend. Then it should be achievable. What will be the measurable, it should be get achievable depending upon the quantum of work. Then it should be realistic. You have to show the realistic figure, or you have to write your objectives should be realistic or the real phenomenon. And depending upon the time constraints or depending upon the current situation, you may frame your objectives. So in short, it may be called as the pillar of the building. And the pillar is one of the most important thing for the building. So we can frame such objectives which is based on the purpose, which is based on your idea and the intention, and should be a SMART one. Okay. Then next to that, that is the research methodology. We have to adopt different kinds of research methods, as I explained. Then the scope, we have to mention whether the college teacher or whether a senior college or junior college teacher. Then in that, we have to make whatever the teachers from the arts or the humanities or like that, we have to make the scope, the limitations, as well as population sampling, we have to take into consideration. There is, as you know, there is one model that is called as Krajewski-Morgan. Krajewski-Morgan table is there, which can use the population sampling ratio. So we can take the help of the particular Morgan table to determine the population and the sampling ratio once it can have a quantifiable and the qualitative data. Suppose the quantity of this particular research is, say, for example, 2000. That is called as population. Then what about their 2000 population? What will be the sampling? It is around 10%. It is around 20%. So Krajewski-Morgan table gives the right direction about deciding the population and the sampling ratio. It is nothing but what? It is a research skeleton. It is your research skeleton. Then you have to design the questionnaire. It should be based on objectives, which is realistic, which is achievable, which is measurable. Depending upon your objectives, you have to design your questionnaire. Then depending upon the hypothesis, what will be stated, what will be the content, we can have questions. And the questions may be of the logical view. Say, for example, yes, no, agree, disagree, like that. Or the scaling also. Say, for example, Likert scale. Say, for example, 1 to 5 scale, 1 to 7 scale, 1 to 10 scale. Like that, the scaling should be there. Or it should be the open-ended. What will be the opinion about a particular respondent for a particular questions? So it includes the questions, includes all. It may be logical, it may be the scaling, or it may be the open-ended questions you may add. Then there are also the different distribution as well as collection techniques are there. All of us are familiar with the either you can go for the physical or the online. It may have Google form, SurveyMonkey, like that. The different distribution as well as collection patterns of questions are there. And the last is not important, limit the questions or the pages. What I understood is from my PhD is that if your questionnaire is big, say around, say for example, 6 pages from both sides, then the respondents, what we call as respondents' response will be low. If it is short, if it includes the logical scaling, he will be happy to write your questionnaire. So limit the questions as well as the pages. Then only you can get your questionnaire filled from the respondents. And what is the important is that here from that the questionnaire, we can get the empirical data. And this empirical data is going to be adopted further for the interpretation of the data. Then only we can draw a different kinds of this, what is called as major findings for this conclusion. So we have to design a questionnaire which is useful to get the empirical data for my research. Then the most important part is called as analysis and interpretation of data and the findings. So before undertaking, whatever the collected questionnaire is there, the data is there, you can get editing and coding. Coding of questionnaire we can make. Say for example, A, B, C, D, say for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, we can make the coding for the each questions and the sub questions in that particular question also we can make the coding. And as per questionnaire, from questionnaire, minutely we can analyze one by one. Question number one, objective number one, what are the questions? What are the sub questions and its analysis? Then prepare easy to understand charts or the diagrams. You can prepare the charts, tables, or the figures in a systematic way. It should be self-explanatory. Okay. Then give the chart, figure, or table number or the caption and refer it into the text of interpretation. Say for example, figure number one relates to this, chapter number one, table number one relates to this, or the chart number is going to explain this. Like that, you have to give the caption, the name, and same that will be referred in your text. Then we can, after that, we can make the descriptive analysis. Before applying descriptive analysis, you must have knowledge about the different descriptive analysis tools. It may be the mean. It will be the skewness, it will be the standard deviation, it will be the different kinds of texts that can be useful for testing of hypothesis. So you must know, understand, and then apply. What happen if you apply? If you don't understand, you can apply. And if the reviewer asks how the figure that can be good or out, then you have to justify that. So for that purpose, you have to understand, you have to know, and then apply that whatever the tests are. The descriptive analysis are there. Then result discussion, table, chart, figure will be well presented as I said, as per need of the quality. Then you have to add the major findings, whatever the inferences are there. Say for example, a particular topic is there, particular question, a particular objective is there, and depending upon the objectives, depending upon that questions included in a particular objectives, I have inferences. Then you can suggest some suggestions, then conclusion. And while writing the conclusion, you have to state the importance of this conclusion, its validity, and generalization to the current situation. And the last, report writing. Here also, you have to limit your the word length or the page length. Because depending upon what is called as your contents, if the contents are enormous, obviously the page length will be increased. So you should add the specific contents, specific observations, specific findings only. Then only your reports come to be a better one. So for that, once we can get it, we can have the qualitative as well as quantitative results that can be visualized from that particular analysis and interpretation of data. And for that particular analysis interpretation data, if we can take your diagram, it should be come to around 1% or 1 to 2%. Because it includes the things which is which is taken from the empirical data. Okay. Then the further work that is called as references, we have to add. It should be accurate, it should be the current, and it should be the accessible one. Then either bibliography or references, you may write from A to Z, alphabetical order, or from 1 to 10, or from the year also, that is 2015 to 2020. And there are, as you know, there are different kinds of style methods are there, given by different associations. So depending upon that, you can make your references. It may be MLA, it may be the ABA, it may be Chicago, it may be IEEE, that is Institution of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, or it should be a journal style or format. Depending upon the journal style, this particular MLA, ABA, Chicago, you may add. One journal or journal have a policy, apart from this MLA or APA, they may undertake their style of methods. Okay, say for example, DISDOC, they may have another style, their own style of writing this particular references. Like that, depending upon that, we have to take into consideration. And there is one example is again how to write the particular references. And lastly, that is acknowledgement. We have to acknowledge. Hello. We have to acknowledge. Acknowledgement about the author. You must take a brief review of yours. What will be your qualification or what will be your the achievement? We can add at the end of this particular reference. So it can be useful for the recognition as well as for the citation purpose. So all these things ranging from what is called as the research question to the references, here we have to take into consideration, and depending upon that priority, we can create or we can do our research. Then certain things we have to keep away from, that is very important from the research point of view, that is the fabrication of the data. We may call as a making of new data, shaping of new data. So avoid that particular things. Whatever the questions are there, depending upon the questionnaire, I can have a data, and depending upon data, I can go for analysis. Depending on analysis, I can have suggestions. There is no fabrication, new fabrication. Okay, so avoid that particular fabrication of data or falsification of data. Say for uncorrected or misrepresented. Sometimes it may be happen in the research. That is, we have to presented the particular thing, but it is misrepresented in certain things. So we have to avoid it, falsification. Then plagiarism is issue, that is the today's burning issue is there. We'll talk later on. Then copy paste, then avoid the self plagiarism also. Nowadays, UGC circular regarding self plagiarism also, and there are some limit of that particular self plagiarism, and what will be the self plagiarism, what is the scope of the particular self-plagiarism is also given. Then avoid unnecessary self-citation. Suppose if I am writing a research on COVID-19, okay, and if I am citing a source from library, science, that was published in my earlier journal or earlier one of the article, then it is, if I cite that particular thing, that is from library science to the COVID, it is irrelevant. So unnecessary self-citation you must avoid. Depending upon the scope, depending upon the relevancy of your title, if it is feasible, you can add it. If it is not feasible, you can't add it. Then avoid introduction of this host authors. Unknowingly addition of names. Sometimes it may happen that the editor will give a name of a particular person to you to add after your name as a ghost author without contributing any kind of research activity. It may be gift authors. Then you must take into consideration this point also. Then avoid the superlative adjectives, what is called as it is very important, excellent, outstanding in the content. So avoid these adjectives. whatever the else figure is there, you must add it. Then avoid the publication in predatory journals, because the predatory journal, it has the fake impact factor. The journal that can be started in this particular, what is say, for example, 19, do you think that it has an impact factor of, say, for example, 4.0? No, because the impact factor is for the last 2 years. So take into consideration the impact factors. Then in these predatory journals, there are no peer review courses. There should be what is called as, they can adopt this APC, that is article posting charges. So once you can patch your journal or your article will be get published without the peer review process, and it can be get published in this high impact factor journals. If you can look at this particular Bella's list, it can give the list of predatory journals. It can be available in, on the internet, that is Bella's list. Afterwards, one we can search and get that particular list of what is predatory journals. So avoid these things, which is misconduct in the research. Then once again, we can have a, what is called as the whatever we have talked, just we can, once again, we can take it. Say for example, the first one is start to read from one point to another. Useful to add more data or the information. If I return one kind of manuscript, read it from one point, not only one point, one line, second line, third line, paragraph, and up to the particular end of this particular figure. So it is useful to add the more data. While reading, you must suggest, or you must have an idea about, oh, this will be an important thing that I should incorporate in my research. So you can add it, or use the color, edit the page content to find more information afterwards. Suppose you included something, what is called technical term, and now I'm writing and don't know about this technical term. You can make it color of the particular phrase. Afterwards, you can make the information about the particular phrase and add it. Then read accurately in this particular healthy and calm environment. Whatever you have prepared manuscript, you can read very accurately, minutely. Especially, you can prefer the morning time to read that particular article. And at that time, you must notice some kinds of the corrections or additions are there. So you can note it. Then after that, you can add the same, put the new data, that is colored, and the print. That is 1 to 6 steps. And repeat these 4 to 6. Say, for example, read accurately in this morning, read, find out the corrections, add the new, again put the new data, print. You can repeat those exercise for 2 and 3 times. Then only we can finalize from your side. From your side, you can finalize. After revising 2 or 3 times, by adding the new data, by adding whatever the things I don't know, by adding the don't know things, the solution on it, like that, read, write, and print, and again the read. That will be the better solution for that. Make the finalization of the particular research. Then from your side, it is okay. If you want, you can show this particular article or manuscript to your friend or expert for his or her review. Understand? He may be your colleague, he may be your teacher, he may be your guide. You can show to your experts for their reviews. More to that, if, as I said earlier, in the while writing the research paper, your language should be clear and unique. So you may consult one of the English teachers, whether I am writing this particular things, whether it is grammatically correct or any kind of syntax error is there, to get it corrected from the English teacher. That too, you can show your manuscript to the statistician also for any kind of the analysis purpose or the empirical data validation. Then content, title, abstract are in line with the content, whether it is content, whether the title and the abstract are aligned with the content, or then you can modify the title. Then you can modify the title or the subtitle. Okay. Earlier to that, upon start like I mentioned that we can come from what is called as research question title to the references. But here, now it can be reverse process. It can be reverse process. Because just only research question is there. Then after addition of the new information, your title, your subtitle may be get changed. Okay. Then topic of the article fit with the journal norms. Once it is there, you share your topic, your title should be fit in the journal norms. The general scope is there, say for example, library science, say for example, social science. Depending upon their particular scope or the norms, you can fit your title. Then match with the journal author guidance. Then onwards, we can prepare that particular write-up or research design in a journal, in a author guidelines given by a particular journal. And this is will be called as research in appropriate context. Then only we can say that our research is in appropriate context. What I'm suggesting is that one second step is very, very important research. You can write one manuscript, okay? Then say, for example, 2 pages, read it again. While reading, 101% we have one kind of an idea, we can add it. Then by adding so many things, once again, we can add it, once you can read it, then again, the new idea, then take the references, then our review literature, we can add it. Like that, the exercise will be done. And that time you can come that our title or abstract should be in line with that particular things. Okay, that is the one second step is very, very important in the research. Then this is the skeleton of the research writing process. It is called with the logical arrangement. Here at the background or the lower level, there is the vision, idea or question statement is there. And the top level, the title, abstract, keyword, reference is there. मगाशी आपण जे बघितलं आपण टॉप पासून खाली आलो मग आता कसं आहे द लॉजिकल वे इज दॅट फ्रॉम द रिसर्च क्वेश्चन टू फिगर डाटा डिस्कशन मेथड्स रिझल्ट इंट्रोडक्शन कन्क्लुजन सजेशन दे कॅन वी कॅन हॅव द टायटल दॅट इज व्हॉट द प्रोसेस ऑफ रायटिंग इज देअर बट वन थिंग कॉमन इज दॅट यू मस्ट हॅव अन आयडिया यू मस्ट हॅव अ क्वेश्चन रिसर्च क्वेश्चन इन द माइंड देन ओनली वी कॅन गो फॉर द फर्दर थिंग्स Then we can add the data, then we can adopt the methodology. Then we may think about suitability of the title. Then we may add the abstract, keyword, or references like that. So this is the process of writing a research and is in, given in logical way, ranging from vision idea and the top is the title or the abstract of the keyword or references. So what are the levels of rejection? Just What is the level of rejection? It must be incorporated with the avoiding such things that we have seen the earlier to that slide. Poor language. If you can include the poor language, there is a possibility of rejection of this particular paper. Or very weak literature survey. You can make the survey, but it is very weak, not strong, not up to the relevancy of a particular topic, not to this objectives. So. It should be strong enough. Then lack of proper data collection methods or the mismatch scope. The scope is college teacher or the scope is senior college teacher and you are writing or you are submitting the junior college teacher like that. So mismatch scope will be there or lack of proper data collection. Then the level of rejection will be increased. Then incomplete data or either the questions from the questionnaires you are not covered. You are skipping some questions. From the questionnaire, already the data of that particular questionnaire is there, but you are to skipping. So that can be called as incomplete data or the questions. So if you can add this, definitely there will be a rejection chances are there. Then deprived or wrong analysis and its interpretation. It is one of the most important thing is that once the data is false, obviously your result will be false. Obviously the interpretation will be false. Obviously the result and the finding will be false. So make it analysis very strong, make it minutely, make it empirically, then only we can achieve our quality in the journal, our quality in the research paper. No correlation with earlier studies. Asa pahu shakte ki apan ata je ghetlela ahe, to aapla research question ahe. So earlier studies sandarbhatla tyacha kay tyacha sambandh hoo shakat nahi like that. So you must correlate how it is there and how it is unique. Now my present topic is this, earlier is this, and my present topic is unique to that particular earlier studies. So there should be a correlation. Then similar or exact study already carried out, if you can take into consideration the already the work is submitted, then there is of no use of writing one more research. So the level of rejection should be increased. So there should be a no innovative novel research question. So level of rejections states about the different criteria, and depending upon that, how we can go for the qualitative and the quantitative research oriented, you have to think about that. So this is all about what is called as how to write a paper like that. Now we are shifting towards the second one, that is called as the fundamentals of the publication. Fundamentals of the publications. So it may be you may publish your paper either in the print form, either in the e-publications. Publish your paper in your subject domain or multidisciplinary. It may be published in the journal or the special issue or the conference proceedings, depending upon that particular things. And there are different kinds of publishing modes. Say for example, traditional, they can have free of charge. You have the traditional method is there. And now the trend is towards this open access or the subscribed or scholarly e-journal publications, which are indexed in reputed international databases like Scopus, Web of Science, like that, so that we can have more number of citations, and the citations ranges are different. Say, for example, Science Citation Index or Arts Humanities Citation Index or Social Science Citation Index. So citation from the, as Dr. Mohan Rajaman sir rightly said, for the NAC purpose or for criteria number 3 purpose, your journal should be published in the indexed journal, and the indexed journal should be get more citation once the author or the authors can be get cited, and depending upon citations you may now recognize, so my credit is this, why I have got such kind of citation, and it can be get published in different kinds of citation indexing. Say for example, SCI, ACI or SSCI, etc., etc. Then objectives plus questions or mapping or relation. Say for example, my one objective is there, and depending upon the objectives, I have a questions, and depending upon that, I can make a one correlation or mapping so that I get the more publication. In general, what happens in the PhD? There are objectives. Say for example, 4 or 5, 6 or 7 objectives are there, and depending upon that, we have to prepare a questionnaire. And in that particular questionnaire, depending upon the objective, we have to frame the questions. Okay, then we can take objective number 1, question number 1, and we can go further. But if we can map this in other way, depending upon the sub questions of a particular question or particular objectives, then it can be going to be published. That should be unique. That should be a what is called as novel idea, which can be useful for publications. It may be within or it may be the outside, like that. Then, as I said, the e-publication, there are different formats of e-publications are there. Say, for example, it may be available in HTML format, it may be available in the PDF format. It have a search browse facility. It may be available on your mobile. It may be available on desktop. It may be available to the user institution access. It may be a customized or discoverable access facilities are there. So all that can be included in this particular e-publication. It may be e-journal, or I said earlier, that is the open access journals. Then follow author's guideline. जसं मगाशी म्हटलं जर्नल होमपेज आहे त्या अनुषंगाने त्यांची जी काही रिक्वायरमेंट आहे जर्नलची टायटल सब्जेक्ट डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द ऑथर गाईडलाईन्स यू हॅव टू राईट और फ्रेम युअर मॅन्युस्क्रिप्ट अँड अपलोड इट. Then uploading steps are there. They have given your login credentials. Okay. Once समजा तुम्हाला वाटलं की बाबा एक जर्नल आहे तर त्याचा जर्नल आपण ई पब्लिशन करणार आहोत तर त्या जर्नलचं आपण काय करणार ते वेबसाईटला जाऊन ते आपल्या लॉग इन आपण घेणार लॉग इन अँड द ईमेल दॅट इज कॉल्ड लॉग इन क्रेडेन्शियल्स. then from that we can add one steps. Say for example, apparently there are 1 to 5 steps, ranging from one should be add the title, second should be add the your upstairs, third will be add your research publication, or prior to that you can add your profile. Like that, there are steps are there. So depending upon the author guidelines, you have to upload your manuscript one by one, and lastly the finish or the success. Then you can think about the duration. What is the duration of my publications? Because generally you can expect, say for example, once uploaded on a particular journal homepage, it may take 3 to 6 months or the 1 or the 2 years also. So you have to make that track. What upon the journal homepage wale nantar kay kartat, tyanchyakade review committee asto. The review committee tila ekas editor tumhala to asan kela jato ani tyancha marfat tumhala questions kiwa revision karne sandarbhatli tumhala te pudhche correspondence karat asta. So think about that is the duration and the track. Then go pre or publication charges, can taken asta like that. Then review process, online correspondence with the assigned editor, guide, question answer session, as I told earlier. Then advantage to author or institution is that once it can be get accepted and get publications, and if it is novel idea, obviously you can get your citation. Once the citation need to be given, obviously you can go for the H index. Once you have H index, you can go for the another index. And once it can be appear, then only we have our ID or we have Google Scholar profile. Like that, the things that can be get added, and you become the expert guide or the reviewer in this case. So think about the publication. Think about how to write a particular manuscript. Then go for the whether what is called as the predatory journals or indexed or cited journals. You have to think about and go for the further things. Then refer fixed priority of the information sources, as I told, from primary to the secondary. That is primary from the book, tertiary from the encyclopedia, or from that particular e-journal to the databases or the search engines. You have to take into consideration. Always acknowledge the source. You have to give the quotation. Whatever you are taking the definitions, you are taking the paragraph. You have to acknowledge that particular source in your research. Choose the right source. Then be aware of the fake in contents or the information report. What happened on the internet? The information is available, but the information is not updated. It may be what is called incomplete information, not updated. It may be the fake. So take into consider, be aware about the particular fake contents or information or report. Then avoid posting of article in so many journals simultaneously. Ekas veli apla haa jo manuscript tayar zalalay to 3-4 journal madhe takneka prayatna karu naka. Avoid that. Because what happened, there are many cases. Samjha eka journal tumhi upload kela, same article dusra journal apply kela, article upload kela, dono thikani acceptance ala tar then copyright issues will be emerged. So avoid that posting of article in so many journals simultaneously. Then use synonymous words, paraphrase, summarization in the write-up to restrict rate of plagiarism. The rate of plagiarism, jo hai, kasa vadnar? Jar tu tumhi copy paste kela asa tar vadnar. Tar tela solution kay hai? You can use the synonymous words for your contents or paraphrase. You can write the things in your own language, in your own words. Summarize in your own words, and take help of your English people. So all these exercise, what we call as use of synonymous words, use of the paraphrase summarization, that will lead to restrict your rate of plagiarism. Okay, then reputable publishers are there. Say for example, Imbrad is there, Village Sage is there. So depending upon that particular content, depending upon the scope, you may approach to a particular reputable publisher and try to upload their particular research paper on their journal website or the journal homepage and follow the author guidelines, and the reviewer, then the editor process will go on. So what the output is, there you have to use the ethical use of information in an efficient way. So information is there, it should be used in ethical and legal way, otherwise of no use. Okay, Then once you have created your research article, then there are different ways of publishing in scholarly communications. It may be your journal article. It may, your article may be get published in the conference. The published article or research can be uploaded in your institutional repositories, or you can provide the link on the website, social medias, or there are different kinds of collaborative networks are there. That is, ResearchGate is there, Kudos is there, or there are different kinds of the collaborative networks are there. You can upload their particular things, or you can make your profile in Google Scholar or POP, Publisher Perish. Here also, we can add your publications. Then only we can have the different kinds of the well-known IDs, either a Scopus ID, either a Vidwan database ID, or the Orchid ID, we may get it after the publication of these things. Then coming to the last point, that is the access to the resources. आता आपण काय बघितलं की हाऊ टू राईट रिसर्च पेपर इट्स पब्लिकेशन अँड हे करत असताना आपण कुठल्या कुठल्या प्रकारचे रिसोर्सेस आपल्याला बघायला पाहिजे वाचायला पाहिजे ब्राउज करायला पाहिजे ते आपण थोडक्यात बघूया. द फर्स्ट दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज युअर लायब्ररी रिसोर्सेस कॉल्ड एज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रिसोर्सेस. द बेसिक प्रायोरिटी इज अगेन द सेम दॅट इज यू कॅन गो फॉर द प्रायमरी रिसोर्सेस ई जर्नल इट मे बी ऑफ द इंडियन इट मे बी ऑफ फॉरेन ओरिजिन ई बुक्स the well-known e-books you may browse, it may be Cambridge, it may be Oxford. Then you can have e-databases as in the second source of information, that is called electronic source of information. In the databases, there are different kinds of databases, say for example, bibliographic. Again, there are different, say for example, OPAC or Econlit, this particular service that can be given by IBSCO, that is related to the economics people. Then full text, we can have a Science Direct, Elsevier Science, Ranger, JSTOR. There are different kinds of databases. Then indexing, abstracting databases, we have the Scopus, Web of Science, or Indian Citation Index, like that. We have so many indexing, abstracting databases are there. There are certain statistical databases are there, say for example, India, STAT, or EPWRF, that is Economic Political Weekly, statistical databases are there. So all these databases, either your library, maybe get subscribed, and use that particular subscribed database for your purpose. Through this infinite system or through the another system, if you require remote access, you can get it. Apart from that subscribed databases, there are sources given by the Implement Center, which includes, as you know, all of you, that is eShoth Sindhu is there, which can use different kinds of the e-journals, the databases from the well-known publishers, ranging from I think 23 or 24 publishers, and apart from that, we have more than plus 10,000 e-resources are there. Or for the college level, there is English program is there. Or we can refer the other sources, for example, EPG Parshala for your reference purpose, or the Shodh Shuddhi, that is a plagiarism portal of Implement. Or you can have the Infed system, that is Implement Access Management System Federation. From that, we can have the remote access to this particular subscribed databases. And from that, we can either we can browse at your home or you are outside the library through this input system. And there are many more. So we can use other particular input resources or the library resources. Apart from that, we have institutional repositories are there. We can refer that, say, for example, input repositories there. In the input repository, we have a lot of sources of information are available. Whatever the events or whatever the publications are made by the Implement Center, it can get available on this IR. And there are a number of institutional repositories are available, or there can be generated by the different institutions, universities or the institutions. Then there are different kinds of portals are there can take into consideration, or ETDs, electronic dissertations are there. Say, for example, Shodh Ganga. It is very excellent source for to know this particular thesis and dissertation for. So we can refer all this. We may call this the library resources. So these library resources varies from library to library, university to university, depending upon their subscription, depending upon their accessibility. So we can refer these sources, write the journal, or to make the publication of your research output. Then apart from that, there are different internet sources are also available. internet sources that can be also available. Say, for example, there are different kinds of search engines are there. We may refer to Google Scholar. Generally, we can refer that particular particular Google Scholar link to know the academic or scholarly literature available, or we can refer the base or the Microsoft Academic that can be developed by Microsoft Corporation, or get the research. Get the research. It can give the different scholarly literature on that particular menu that is called as get the research. We may have different kinds of digital repository, as I told, institutional repositories. It may be of National Digital Library of India, or e-social sciences, or OSTER. So we can refer either DLI, NDLI, or the implemented repository, or depending upon your source, or depending upon your content, you may refer more than one repository. Then there are different kinds of the open data sources are available. Say, for example, Census of India, or international data, or ICSSR data portal. Say, for example, Aadhaar, that is called Aadhaar Trust. There are a number of open databases sources are available. You may refer it. Then there are, apart from that, there are open access resources are there. Say, for example, DOJ, Directory of Open Access Journal, or books, or open access thesis and dissertations, or the Shodhanga. You may refer it as an internet source. And you can get a lot of information from that. And you use that particular information while writing your research paper. There is one interesting thing is that this paper digest provides a solution or summarize the paper with the help of AI, that is artificial intelligence, in 3 minutes of time. What will be the future of this paper digest is that upon article refer karto apan kay karto palanda tesa abstract bagto title bagto ani aplyala yogya vatla tar apan पुढे तो आर्टिकल पूर्ण जो आहे 3-5 पान ते आपण सगळं वाचतो. मग याच्यामध्ये काय होणार की पहिल्या पानापासून शेवटच्या पानापर्यंत 10-5 पान आपण सगळं पूर्ण वाचण्यामध्ये आपला वेळ जातो. तर याच्यामध्ये एक त्यांनी फॅसिलिटी दिली पेपर डायजेस्ट मध्ये, व्हॉट एव्हर द आर्टिकल इज देअर, आयदर इट इज द पीडीएफ ऑर दिस डीवाय, जस्ट अपलोड इट ऑन पेपर डायजेस्ट .com अँड विद इन a fraction of, say, for example, 1 minute or 3 minutes, it can summarize your paper highlights or the research findings. तुमचे बाबा जे पेपर तुम्ही बाबा 5-10 पर्यंत वाचणार होता तेच तुम्हाला 3 मिनिटांमध्ये त्याचं जे काय जिस्ट आहे, त्याचं काय समराइजेशन आहे, तुम्हाला 1-2 मिनिटांमध्ये लगेच तुम्हाला दाखवायची व्यवस्था आहे पेपर डायजेस्टमधून करण्यात आलेली आहे. जस्ट फॉर दॅट पर्पज यू हॅव टू रजिस्टर युअर email address, make the registration, and after completing registration, you can upload your PDF or DOI file, and from that, this paper digest will summarize this particular thing in 3 minutes, and you can have that particular things. Artificial intelligence madhyamatun tumhala te apan bahu shakto. This is gist of the paper. Then we may refer the reference management tools. There are different reference management tools are there that will be available on the internet. It may be this Jotero, it may be this Mendeley, it may be the EndNote. There are a number of reference management tools are there. We may refer it. Then there is one website is called as Sherpa Homeo, where we can get the information about the publishers, policies, and self-telling. It is interesting to know that particular website, Sherpa Homeo, where we can get different kinds of these corporate policies and the self-archiving, the things are there. Then again, there are different kinds of the programs of diverse are there. It may be freely available, it may be subscribed, and well known are, as you know, Authenticate, Turnitin, or Sorbonne, and many more internet resources are there. The some magash mota library resources, many more resources, internet resources, many more are there. So we can take the help of either this or this and try to write, try to publish your research output. Then the last will be the journal selection. Journal selection. How to choose the journal. So magashi sarani mhatlo ki UGC ne mandate kelala aahe ki publication hone khup garjeche aahe, NAAC sathi NIRB sathi khup mahatvache aahe. Tar tyachyasathi apan aple journal kasa find out karnar. We can make the help of your UGC care list. Tumhala mahitach aahe tyachyamadhye group 1 aahe, 2 aahe, Scopus industry journal chi yadi vegli aahe, Scopus che dusra sodun tyachi yadi vegli aahe. Tar tyachyamadhye tumhi bagha, त्याचा ईसीचा नंबर बघा, त्याचं जर्नल प्रोफाईलला जाऊ, त्याच्या जर्नलच्या होमपेजला जाऊ, त्याचं कंटेंट्स बघा, अँड यू कॅन सिलेक्ट युअर जर्नल. ते सिलेक्ट करताना तुम्ही त्याची पिरियडिसिटी पण बघा. वेदर द जर्नल इज गोइंग टू बी पब्लिश्ड इन मंथली, क्वार्टरली, सिक्स मंथली, इयरली. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दॅट आणि आपल्याकडे किती टाइम आहे त्या अनुषंगाने, पिरियडिसिटीच्या अनुषंगाने वी हॅव टू सिलेक्ट दॅट पर्टिक्युलर जर्नल. ओके, देन पब्लिकेशन प्रोसेस तुम्ही बघायला पाहिजे. पीयर रिव्ह्यू आहे, ब्लाइंड रिव्ह्यू आहे का, पैसे देऊन पब्लिश करणारे आहेत, अँड द टाइम पिरियड फॉर दॅट. सो पब्लिकेशन प्रोसेस वी हॅव टू अंडरस्टँड. There is one website that is called as Think, Check, Submit. Think, there are something we have to think. Check, we have to check something and submit. Then only we can have, they can suggest the whatever will be the publication tools useful for your manuscript. Or either we can go for the DOAJ, Director of Open Access Journals. There are a lot of open access journals are there. It's DOAJ. So from that also we can select the appropriate journal for your research publications. Or there are publishers' websites, say for example, Elsevier, Emerald, Wiley, or ACS. They are going to support the author. Say for example, there is one hyperlink, Elsevier.com. Elsevier.com, where it can give the press towards the author. Suppose your manuscript is ready, then we can approach to Elsevier. Then Elsevier tells you whether the manuscript is prepared in a well manner, and depending upon your contents, they can suggest the suitable title for that. So the publisher's website you may refer for journal selection. Then the journal metrics we have to know while selecting a particular journal. Say for example, impact factors, and I told earlier, number of citation of article in 2 years, dual number of articles, from that ratio we can have impact factors. And peer-reviewed journals have more impact factors. There will be no what is called as review process. And if it is published recently, it the impact factor is or is ranging to the high. How it should come, I don't know. So you have to take into consideration the impact factor of the particular journal. Or you can refer the SCIMAGO journal ranking. That is one source where you can take, where we can make the metrics about the journal. Or we have Google Scholar metrics also for the metrics of the journal. Or Altmetrics, that is a new term that can be useful for social media, very popular in social media. Or we can refer this indexing databases like the Google Scholar, Thomson Reuters, etc. From that thing, you can select journal suitable to your article. And while selecting, one of the most important is you have to go for the journal metrics. Journal metrics. Take note these impact factors. What are the citations? What will be the what is called as the metrics? What will be the Google Scholar metrics? What are the SGR ranking for a particular journal? Then only we can select a particular journal and upload your paper on that particular journal. Okay. So I conclude our summarization of this particular paper is that whatever the resources I told on, it may be library, it may be internet, it may be other, they are not reliable. They are changing at fast speed. They are changing at fast speed. They are not reliable. Reliable are certain things, then the new data will be added like that. So you can refer it, you can use it for the time being. Focus should be on qualitative and no research outputs. Your focus should be on quality, not to the quantity. Then only we can have what is called as your citations will be grouped, or your the article will get published in the reputed journal. It may be peer-reviewed journal. Then it makes the impact on citations. Do you think that my citation should cross 5 digits? Like that. Think about that. Citation only we can achieve once we have a empirical data, once we have what is called as novel idea, once we have relativity of the particular output data, then the people will cite. Otherwise, it's of no use. So try to develop your citations as many as it may be of 5 digits, 4 digits, 2 digits, depending upon that. Then make the collaboration either at the international level or the global level. Say for example, Scopus ID or this Orchid ID, it can recognize your research output at a global level. जसं मी पहिल्या स्लाइडला म्हटलं की अमेरिका टॉपला आहे, इंडिया पाचव्या नंबरला आहे, जर तुमचा तुमचे सर्टिफिकेशन वाढले, पेपर आउटपुट वाढले, देन तरच तुम्ही पुढे जाऊ शकता. तर ते पाच मध्ये पाचच्या म्हणजे पाचच्या पुढे जाऊन दोन नंबरला आपण येऊ शकतो. सो थिंक अबाउट दॅट, दॅट इज द इंटरनॅशनल ग्लोबल कोलॅबोरेशन, देन ओनली वी कॅन गो. तुम्ही असं करू शकता की बाबा माझं हे आर्टिकल मी तयार करत आहे आणि माझ्या डोमेन मध्येच एक व्यक्ती आहे जो फॉरेनचा आहे आणि त्याचा देखील डोमेन सेमच आहे. Try to approach that particular thing or particular author, and we can make a collaborative research or collaborative paper. And we can easily find out their particular name either from research gate or this collaborative networks. From that point of view, we can make the international collaboration and get published journals. Then devote time in the research with patience. You have to devote your time. Because in the research or in this up to the age of up to the what is called time of publication, the lot of time that can get passed out. You may know how you may create some kind of peak. You have no patience, but unless and until you have to maintain your patience in the research. काय काय वेळ काय असतंय बघा, आपल्याला माहित आहे की आता रिसर्च गाईड त्यांना माहित आहे की विद्यार्थी त्यांच्याकडे काम करतात, पहिल्या वर्षी फ्लो हा जास्त असतो, त्याच्यानंतर हळू कमी होतो, असं नाही चालणार. पहिल्या वर्षापासून शेवटपर्यंत तुमचा रिसर्च फ्लो जो आहे काम करायचा तो वाढलाच पाहिजे, त्याला वेळ द्यायला पाहिजे आणि आपण काम करायला पाहिजे. काही वेळा असं पण झालेलं आहे की ह्या लेंथी प्रोसेस मध्ये आपलं रिसर्च आपण डिले करत गेल्यानंतर अशी गोष्ट येते की रिसर्च काय होता हे देखील आपण विसरून जायची पण शक्यता आहे. तर अशी देखील शक्यता होऊ शकते. त्यासाठी डिवोट युअर व्हॅल्युएबल टाइम फॉर द रिसर्च विथ द पेशन्स. पेशन्स ठेवा. आज नऊ उद्या 100% तुमचा जो रिझल्ट आहे, तुमचा जो रिसर्च आहे तो पब्लिश होणारच आहे. त्यासाठी तुम्ही वेळ द्यायला पाहिजे. जसं मी मागे म्हणतो, वन सेकंड जी मागाची मेथड वापरली, 3-4 वेळा 5-6 वेळा वाचा, जे करेल आहे वाचा, एडिट करा, रिव्ह्यू करा, रेफरन्सेस घ्या, वाचा, पुन्हा रिव्ह्यू करा, एका दुसऱ्या पिक्चरला दाखवा, तुमच्या फ्रेंडला दाखवा, पुन्हा एकदा अपलोड करा. आणि असं केल्यानंतरच तुमचं रिसर्च चांगला होणार आहे आणि याला वेळ द्यावा लागेल आणि वेळ दिल्यानंतर तुम्हाला ते चांगल्याचे आउटपुट देखील मिळतील. And last but not least, we have to je tumhi research karnar ahe ti ethical based anushangana kara. Karan ka ata mahita aahe plagiarism aahe, self plagiarism aalela aahe kiwa ani kai tari vayacha aahe, tar tyacha vapar apan ethical based nusar karnar aahe, jene karun plagiarism chya chakravyuhamadhye apan adkanar nahot ani aapli research changla honar. Then only we can go for this international recognition. Then only we have get more on NAC or NF ranking or this mandate for it. And then only we can reach to intended your audience or the academic fraternity. That is your target. Who should I? Maza research output kay, maza citation evde ahet, maza books evde ahet, maza publications evde ahet. That is your profile. You may call as Vidwan profile. Just like in Vidwan madhe, Vidwan madhe asas hai. Te baba tumchi publications kiti ahet, research publications kiti ahet, book chapters kiti ahet, conference kiti ahet. कॉम्प्रेस मध्ये तुमचं ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज किती आहेत, तुमचं वय एरिया कुठला कुठला आहे, तुमची कोऑथर कोण कोण आहेत, लाईक दॅट इट कॅन बी गेट. आणि ह्याचा वापर तुम्ही विद्वान डेटाबेस ते नंतर कुठल्याही बाबा ते कमिटीवर करतील, कुठल्या तुमचं नाव सजेस्ट करतील इंटरनॅशनल लेवलला, कुठल्या कमिटीवर करतील, लाईक दॅट यू कॅन गो ॲट दिस पर्टिक्युलर थिंग. ओके, सो थँक्यू फॉर पेशन्स लिसनिंग ऑफ माय प्रेझेंटेशन. अँड वन्स अगेन आय थँक all the team, especially the Pracharya of this college, Sadhguru College, Sadhguru Gadge Maharaj College, Karar Mohan, Dr. Mohan Rajamani sir, Kalan Shetty sir, and my research student Mahesh Gaikwad, and all the team of this particular college for organizing such a event. I am now interested in question answer session. Over to Mahesh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for very much for such an informative session. Now session is open for discussion. Sir, shall you your screen?
Yes, yes sir.
Thank you. I have some questions on chatbox. I am going to read it. First question asked by Ashwini Tatukuri, Department of English. What is mean by edge index?
Okay, each index, as I told earlier, there are different kinds of the citation parameters are there. And there are different kinds of these indexes are there that can be given by, say, for example, social science index or science citation index or the arts humanities citation index. Here, we can have citations are there. Each index is there that is developed by this Hirsch, that is something Hirsch, or the name of the divisor is there. At the time of the calculation, each index card, what do you do? माझे समजा एक 10 पब्लिकेशन्स आहेत, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 असे 10 पब्लिकेशन्स आहेत. एका माझ्या पब्लिकेशनला मला सायटेशन 10 मिळाले, दुसऱ्या पब्लिकेशनला मला 12 सायटेशन मिळाले, तिसऱ्या पब्लिकेशनला मला 8 मिळाले. असं करून मी 10 पर्यंत येणार. किंवा एक म्हणजे हे 10 लेवल येईपर्यंत असं मला होणार की माझा जो का पब्लिकेशन्स आहेत त्याला इक्वल नंबर ऑफ सायटेशन्स मिळणार आहेत. म्हणजे मला असं म्हणायचं आहे की से फॉर एक्झाम्पल फॉर द माय फोर्थ publication, I have got 4 what is called as citations, then the H index of my is 4. That is how it can get calculated. It is a very simple method to calculate that particular. Depending upon what your publication and citations received, that is the maximum number of citations received for the particular paper, when it exactly match your H index that can be generated. It is automatically generated either through this Google Scholar or the other methods. Next.
Okay, thank you, sir. Some participants asked through YouTube channel chat box. One of them, Bapu Rao Jadhav, asked, what is the difference between peer journal and reviewed journal?
Okay, that's a nice question. Say, peer journal, peer means a group. Or what is called a group of experts. So there is, if you can look at this particular journal, then it has what is called as peer review committees there. Peer review committees there, where they can have the experts from different domain. Say for example, library science domain people are there. Along with that, the multidisciplinary domain experts are there. And once you can put out your journal article in that particular, it can go through the peer review process. And depending upon the journal policy, say for example, in the peer review committee, there are say for example 2 or 3 persons, or more than 5 persons. And out of that 5 persons, if 2 or 3 persons are going to give a positive sign regarding publication, then the journal will be get published. Same thing can be applied in the review paper also. You are reviewed. There is one word that is called as not. Linked with this peer review means reviewed is there. Means what? Suppose I uploaded the journal article and the editor, assigned editor, can have some doubt, some clarification about that the content. Then it can go for the review. It can go for the review. And from the author point of view, he can add, he can review whatever the questions raised by the editor and submit it. Like that, peer review process will go on 2 or 3 times, and at once time it will be, the editor will be happy, and then only you can get published. That is called peer review. That is a group of people who are working on that, and it can direct your the progress of your what is called a journal and the guidance for that particular thing for publication of the journal.
Okay. Okay. आमच्या कॉलेजच्या क्रायटेरिया नंबर 3 चेअरमन आहेत मानसी पाटील मॅडम. त्यांचा एक प्रश्न आहे, SSR भरत असताना सायटेशन स्कोपस किंवा वेब ऑफ सायन्स असे त्यांनी मेन्शन केले आहे नॅटने, पण आपण गुगल स्कॉलरचे सायटेशन देऊ शकतो काय तिथे?
नाही सर, कारण काय झालंय की ज्यावेळी तुम्ही आता SSR भरत आहे, बरोबर आहे, तुमच्याकडे जर करता स्कोपसचा ऍक्सेस नाही आहे, वेब ऑफ सायन्सचा पण ऍक्सेस नाही आहे, तर बाबा तुमच्या पास परंतु विद्यापीठात ओपन स्कोपस आणि सबस्क्रिप्शन भरलेला आहे, तुम्ही इथं येऊ शकताय. त्याचं बाबा तुमच्या कॉलेजचं नाव टाकून तुमचे सायटेशन घ्या, त्याचे सगळे डाटा घ्या, आणि यू कॅन अपलोड इट. सेम थिंग कॅन बी अपलोड इन केस ऑफ द WOS, दॅट इज वेब ऑफ सायन्स साठी देखील तुम्ही असू शकता. तुमच्याकडे आता ऍक्सेस नाही आहे, परंतु वेब ऑफ सायन्स मध्ये तुमचं ते ऍक्सेस तुम्ही घ्या, तुमच्या इन्स्टिट्यूटचं नाव टाका, तुमचे नंबर ऑफ सायटेशन घ्या, आणि तुम्ही टाकू शकताय. कारण का हे एकदा टाकल्यानंतर तुम्हाला सांगतो का सेम प्रॉब्लेम आपल्या ध्यानकी विद्यापीठातून आला होता. हे टाकल्यानंतर ज्यावेळी तुम्ही SSR सबमिट करतायत, तर NAC DVB ज्यावेळी करते तर ते पुन्हा सर्च करते, आणि तुम्ही टाकलेला जो का डाटा आहे ते डाटा तो स्कोपस किंवा वेब ऑफ सायन्सच्या त्यांच्या डाटाबेस मधून मॅच करून घेते किंवा ते व्हॅलिड आहे की नाही बघते आणि तुम्हाला ते विचारते वेदर युअर सायटेशन इज लाईक दिस इट इज रेंजिंग टू दिस अँड दिस विच विल बेनिफिशियल टू यू देन यू कॅन टेक इट. कारण काय क्रॉस चेक होते नॅक कडनं पुन्हा क्रॉस चेक होतेच तुम्ही जो काय बाबा एसआर मध्ये भरलेला आहे आणि तुमची जी सायटेशन डाटाबेसेसच्या माध्यमातून जी काही माहिती काढली ती नॅक कडनं पुन्हा क्रॉस चेक होत आहे आणि झाल्यानंतर आपण म्हणू शकतो की बाबा ही रेंज आपली चांगली आहे तुम्ही कन्सिडर करा आणि जेवढी जी जास्त रेंज आहे ती आपण घ्यावी जेणेकरून आपल्या नॅकच्या पॉईंटच्या वेटाच्या दृष्टिकोनातून आपण होऊ शकतो आणि ऍक्सेस तुमच्याकडे असेल तर यू कॅन कम इन द युनिव्हर्सिटी किंवा ज्या ठिकाणी ऍक्सेस असेल त्या ठिकाणी तुम्ही घेऊ शकते. आणि तुम्हाला वाटतं तुमच्याकडे पैसे म्हणजे फंड्स असेल यू मे सबस्क्राईब स्कोपस इट मे बी चार्जेस अराउंड 22 lakhs पर इयर इफ यू आर फॉर्चुनेट.
ओके ओके थँक्यू सर. लास्ट क्वेश्चन आहे जर्नल सेल्फ इंडिकेटेड इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर इज इट व्हॅलिड ऑर नॉट.
रिपीट
जर्नल इफ सेल्फ इंडिकेटेड इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर जर्नलनी स्वतःचा इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर दिला असेल सेल्फ इंडिकेटेड इज इट व्हॅलिड ऑर नॉट.
मग सांगितल्याप्रमाणे इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर जो काउंट केला जातो तो 2 वर्षा पाठीमाग पासून आता येणार म्हणजे समजा आता आपल्या 20 वर्षाचा इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर जर बघाच असेल तर तो 18-19 किंवा 17-18 रेंज मध्ये करून त्याची पब्लिशन एवढ्या त्यानुसार ते काढला जातो. समजा हे जर्नल समजा 2020 मध्ये पब्लिश होत असेल आणि त्याचा जो काही इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर दाखवत असेल इट इज इनव्हॅलिड इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर व्हेरी क्लिअर इट इज इनव्हॅलिड. तर तुम्ही ज्यावेळी मगाशी मी सांगितल्याप्रमाणे जर्नल सिलेक्ट करत असताना त्याचा इम्पॅक्ट प्रोटेक्टर मी एवढ्यासाठी बघा म्हणतो त्याचं तुम्ही जर्नल बेस्ट वे काय करा की तुम्ही जर्नलचं होमपेज ओपन करा त्याच्यामध्ये त्याची आर्काईव्ह बघा आणि आर्काईव्ह किती वर्ष पाठीमागचे आहेत बघा से 5 वर्षा पाठीमागचे आहेत 10 वर्षा पाठीमागचे आहेत तरच तुम्हाला त्याचा सांगता तुम्हाला की जर्नल इम्पॅक्ट प्रोटेक्टर दिलेला आहे तो करेक्ट आहे का नाही काय ठिकाणी काय बघा जर्नल 14 वर्षानंतर त्याचे समजा आर्काईव्ह काय नसतील आणि इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर हाय असेल तर काय समजा आपण नाही त्याचा इम्पॅक्ट फॅक्टर हा फॉल्स म्हणजे फॉल्स टेक्निकने काढलेला आहे दॅट इज नॉट इनकरेक्ट. तर त्याचे आर्काईव्ह बघा आर्काईव्ह मध्ये पुन्हा त्याचे बाबा अब्स्ट्रॅक्ट बघा फुल टेस्ट बघा त्याला ऍक्सेस आहे का बघा आणि असेल तरच यू कॅन गो फॉर पब्लिकेशन अदरवाइज नो.
ओके काही पार्टिसिपंट आहेत फीडबॅक देऊ इच्छित आहेत त्यामध्ये मानसी पाटील मॅडम आहेत आमच्या कॉलेजच्या हा मानसी पाटील मॅडम तुमच्याकडून अनम्यूट करा. हॅलो मानसी पाटील मॅडम तुमच्याकडून अनम्यूट करा.
हॅलो.
हा मॅम बोला.
हा सर आपल्या महाविद्यालयाचे प्राचार्य डॉक्टर राजमाने सर या वेबिनारचे रिसोर्स पर्सन डॉक्टर प्रकाश बिलावरे सर आयक्यूएससी कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर कल्याण शेट्टी सर आणि हा वेबिनार ऑर्गनायझर करणारे आपल्या कॉलेजचे लायब्रेरियन गायकवाड सर आणि सर्व पार्टिसिपंट सर्वप्रथम मी सर्व ऑर्गनायझिंग टीमला धन्यवाद देते कारण ह्या लॉकडाऊनच्या पिरियडमध्ये तुम्ही अतिशय उपयुक्त आणि मार्गदर्शक विषयावरती हा वेबिनार ऑर्गनाईज केलेला आहे. आपल्याला सर्वांनाच माहित आहे की नॅकच्या 3rd क्रायटेरियामध्ये रिसर्च पेपर रायटिंग साठी खूप महत्व आहे आणि त्याच्यासाठी पब्लिकेशन साठी सुद्धा खूप गरजेचं आहे. जसं की सुरुवातीला प्रिन्सिपल सरांनी आपल्याला सर्वांना सांगितलं की रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश करणं नॅकसाठी जे गरजेचं आहे परंतु ते रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश करताना कुठल्याही जर्नलमध्ये न करता तो रिसर्च पेपर आपण वेल रेप्युटेड जर्नलमध्ये किंवा ज्याला स्कोपस सायटेशन वगैरे आहे अशा ठिकाणी पब्लिश करणं गरजेचं आहे. तर हे पब्लिश करत असताना बऱ्याचशा अडचणी आमच्यासारख्या लोकांना येत होत्या परंतु या वेबिनारमध्ये बिलावरे सरांनी अतिशय विस्तृतपणे अगदी बेसिक्स जे आहेत पेपर रायटिंगचे तिथून पासून ते याच्यामध्ये कुठले इथिक्स आपण पाळायला पाहिजे इथंपर्यंत सर्व गोष्टी अतिशय विस्तारपूर्वक आपल्याला सांगितलेल्या आहेत आणि ह्या वेबिनारचा आपल्या सर्व कॉलेजच्या स्टाफला त्याचप्रमाणे बाहेरच्या लोकांनी अतिशय मार्गदर्शन होईल त्याचं आणि याचा पेपर पब्लिकेशन मध्ये आपण चांगल्या प्रकारे वापर करून आपले पेपर चांगल्या रिसर्च पेपर मध्ये आपण पब्लिश करू अशी मी सरांना ग्वाही देते. थँक्यू सर.
थँक्यू मॅडम. यानंतर सचिन जाधव आहेत हिंदी डिपार्टमेंटचे, त्यांना ही फीडबॅक द्यायचा आहे. सचिन जाधव सर, तुमच्याकडून व्हिडिओ चालू करा आणि अनम्यूट करा. हॅलो, हां सर बोला.
सबसे पहले बिलावर सर जी को मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगा, बहुत बढ़िया सेशन रहा. उन्होंने शोधालेख की बारीकियों को हमारे साथ साझा किया, शीर्षक से लेकर उन्होंने बहुत बढ़िया ढंग से प्रस्तुत की. शोध उपयोगी संसाधनों की जानकारी हमें दी, इसलिए मैं उनका धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करना चाहता हूँ. दूसरी बात, इस लॉकडाउन के पीरियड में इस वेबिनार की टीम ने ये जो बढ़िया आयोजन किया वो भी इसके लिए धन्यवाद के पात्र है, और हमारे महाविद्यालय के प्रधानाचार्य जिन्होंने हम सबको ये अवसर उपलब्ध कराया, इसलिए मैं उनको भी धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ. बिलावर सर जी, मैं आपसे एक बात कहना चाहता हूँ कि आपने जो बताया, ऐसा नहीं था कि हम सब इससे अनभिज्ञ थे, लेकिन आपने जो बारीकियां बताई जिससे शोधालय के जो तत्व है वो बहुत बढ़िया ढंग से हम समझ गए. दूसरी बात, इन बारीकियों के कारण हम अपने शोधालय की स्तरीयता को निश्चित तौर पर बढ़ाएंगे, और आपने जिस प्रकार से रेफरेंस के संदर्भ में खासतौर से जो मेरे और APAA के संदर्भ में जो बात की वो मेरे लिए खासतौर से बहुत उपयुक्त होगी. तो एक बार आप सबके लिए, इसके लिए आप सबको धन्यवाद.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, I would like to request Dr. S.R. Savan, sir, Vice Principal of HGM College, Karad. Please propose vote of thanks of today's webinar. Savan, sir, please unmute your mic. Hello, Savan sir, please unmute your mic.
Honorable Principal Dr. Rajmane Sahib, respected Dr. Prakash Bilwar, Assistant Librarian, Barrister Bala Sahib Kardekar, Library and Knowledge Resource Center, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. Respected Professor Dr. Kalyan Shetty, Coordinator IQAC and Autonomous College. Respected Gaikwad Sir, Librarian, Keshora Power Library, ACM College, Karad. Respected Principals of Mentee Colleges and dear participants. It gives me an immense pleasure to propose a vote of thanks. At the outset, on behalf of us all, I express the deepest thanks to the resource person Dr. Prakash Bilwar for his systematic, scholarly and intellectual discourse on efficient measures to be taken while writing a research paper, its publication and access to e-resources. Bilwar sir, I thank you for one more reason. And that is, you gave us an opportunity to listen to your good English. I express my deep sense of gratitude to our dynamic principal, Dr. Rajmane Sahib, for his constant encouragement, moral and financial support to organize such events. I also express my sincere thanks to Professor Dr. Kalyan Shetty and librarian Gaikwad sir for the successful organization of this webinar. Finally, I thank all the principals of Mentee Colleges and participants for their tremendous response and wholehearted participation. Thank you, one and all. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Now, I would like to request all participants feedback form on your WhatsApp group, which we have created for this webinar. You will get certificate through mail. As the certificate auto-generated, please enter your details properly in the feedback form.
So now I would like to thanks all the participants once again. Thank you very much. Have a good day.